Hello for Tuesday, the last day of the month. That's August 31st. And on Monday, it was not great. Look, here's the 15-minute Standard & Poor's 500. And you can see on Friday when it moved up, it got to this gap that's here. But it wasn't able to even fill it before. You know, that's... If you get halfway there, you might as well go all the way. All the way would be a place that people would be shorting. But halfway, that's kind of wimpish. Anyway, it played out, and look at it drop down. We'll get to the extended chart showing the trend line in just a second. Let's look at something more pleasing to the eye. Look, we do still have gold, just went sideways. Nothing much happening there. But these are some stocks you might want to watch if we have some extended, if we do break down here, if this is the top for a while. Because look at silver. Silver was down like pennies. So it's just sitting here. This isn't silver directly. This is ProShares Ultra for silver. This is the one probably that you're trading, maybe not. But you could be, because this pays double the percentage moves, and the moves aren't so fantastic that you're going to get messed up too much with them, like sometimes with some of those that just move wildly. And of course, a GDX Renko, that's still on the buy, even with these small pullbacks. If we look here at our Williams, at our CCI, this is still above our in our buying area here, so no problem. And when this dips down, when we have the parabolic SAR go above the pattern, or when we break down under this 100 line here, then will be time to sell that. Now here's the Dow. This is the daily, and you know that we had bounced on Friday. We mentioned here was a perfect buy point when it come in action on Thursday, and then on Friday continued up, and we gave up mostly all those gains again. So if it breaks back below this area, and like it's not even as low was 99.36, but actually, when we look at a short time frame chart, it's broken the trend line now that the trend line's moved up a little bit higher than that. But those are areas to watch, because a break there probably go down to this, could indeed go back down to test this 9600 area, or could bounce somewhere in between. Keep your eye on the Williams indicator up here, which dropped back to 64. If it gets down below 80 again, then it's getting into the oversold territory. Here on the 15-minute Dow, you can see it closed exactly at this trend line. Actually, in the futures, it dropped a little bit below after hours. This is the cash market, so it's not a good-looking chart. It shouldn't end the day like that, because a drop could bring it down to test this trend line, as we say, and back down to test these other lows. At the moment, it could bounce. There is the end of the month, which means there could be window dressing. There could be possibility of buying. There's young traders on board. The staff is light. Okay, here's a chart, a ProStreet shared in the chat room. I hope he doesn't mind I'm showing it here. Here, these are daily charts going back from, you can see, 2009. These lows were the March 2009, the top one being the Dow. And this first trend line is the dip in July of 2009, hitting up to the July, you know, the one-year line, hitting the July low of this year. And this, we're very close to that level right now. And so actually the level depends on if we're using this little shorter term black line or the longer term blue line. But obviously if it gets below like 97.46, I think we figured basically this blue line is right now a little bit higher, the other line. But you can look yourself on your own charts doing a yearly like this and seeing exactly where that point is. But you can see it's close. So break there is not good at all. And likewise, we had the S&P 500. We're also at the shorter-term black line right now. I mean, that's where it closed right there. So a dip below there is probably going to take it to the lower one. That might be as low as it's also a moving target. At the moment, it's below 1,000, maybe around 995. Because it's moving up, and every day it's going to be a little different level. But you can check, just pointing out that they're very close to those lines, and a break there is not good, because then you really have to recover from that. So we're at a level where we could bounce, and here we've got the 60-minute chart of this S&P, and here we can see at 10:45 is this support from 1, 2, 3 or 4 candles. One time it did dip below and tried the low from the 25th, so you can look at that as well. But here we've broken this one little trend line and down to this area basically where we closed, just a little bit above it. So 10:45, and it goes down, then we're 10:40 area, and below that we've got a ways to fall. And you can see when we moved up, Williams didn't even get up to the 50%, the 50 line, which it should have done. And here it shows the Fibonacci movement up when S&P moved up last week. It should have continued today if we wanted to get this bounce that we hoped that would get it eventually to the 50% retrace from the recent high. That would bring it up to maybe even as much as 1070. Okay, here we've got the Russell, and you can see even though that was the strongest one of the group we showed in the weekend newsletter, today it was one of the weakest, falling 2.5%, so down as much as it went up the day before, and it's back at this trend line. So, you know, obviously the market's been one of these that's very difficult for trading because we don't get, other than the downtrend we had 4 days in a row, and over here 4 days in a row, we don't get a lot of days up. And so we could on a Tuesday, of course, have a turnaround, but otherwise it's look at this low where it was before, 588, and if it gets down to that level, that was likely to be a bounce at least the first time for short-term trading. The banks also gave back their gains. We said finally it ran right into resistance, so that was good. It needed to break above it, was unable to, so it pulled back as well. And we've got FAS, that the financial bull. And of course, this pulled back, and so we look instead for the bear fund, FAZ, and that made its good gains. It's up 5.5% for the day. So this is the one you want to watch. If we do indeed break down further, if they break support, and financials break support as well, they don't have much support. If they break lower than their lows, then FAZ would be the trade, one of the possible trades for that. And I think Playback in the chat room, we mentioned, by the way, SCO, because we haven't talked about it in a while. Because as oil's been talked about a lot, and we haven't even talked about it much in the newsletter because it's not so interesting, and it looks like it's just going to go lower, that's all, over time. If it does start moving lower, oil itself, talking about the double ETFs, SCO is one for crude oil, and you can see it was just kind of a middle day here. This, if we use this top trend line, I don't think it's so valid, this one from the high to this low, because it's using this gap up candle. I think this is more valid, the lower one that we have across. So if we can get above that, that's around 16. This may be work out. So this would be areas to watch. I'd put it back over the 200-day moving average and back over, I think, this trend line, which is valid. So back above 16 may be a trade. Otherwise, if it goes down further, just watch for possible supports. And, of course, depending on what happens with weather, that can affect the price of oil short-term anyway. Now, when we mentioned some of the stocks that have been stronger, you know, we had several, I think four or five in the last week, silver or gold stocks that did move up on good volume, and they pulled back on Monday on low volume. For instance, Hecla Mining here, you can see the move up on Friday, very good high volume and low volume on the pullback right here. These are ones to watch as they pull back for possible entries, because as the near support, we can buy them, and if they break that support, you can sell with minor losses or buy little bits of them. And then as they move up, if things turn on the upside, you can add to positions. That's one way. A TSL, a solar that had moved up on high volume, down on light volume. But this is, again, in an area where if it can hold support, it's likely to move back up to this high level. And if it doesn't hold support, fine, then we won't buy it. But watch this, and it can be bought into those areas. SLW continued up, but you can see it has probably a reversal candle. This is very typical. Watch for a possible reversal, and then watch that one on the way as it comes back for a possible buy. Okay, we've got additions to the watch list. And actually, most of these are long. They are all but one are long plays, even with the market going down. But they're set up that way, and the market can change any day if it wants to. And so we can present you what we see. And of course, in the agriculture sector, this has had a bullish crossover with the 200-day going below the 50-day. So AGU, as it gets above the 70.58, could be a buy once again. So we're not buying at the moment. We need some more strength there, and that could come. CGA would be a short underneath the $10, and you can see it's not a good looking chart. Here we had two up days, which I haven't drawn it, but you can see that this is a bear flag. When it drops down like this and then moves up wimpy on this little angle, you could have drawn a flag and it dropped out of that. So, and on high volume here on the other drop as well, it's likely it's going lower. So CGA short under about that $10 area. Dell's been trying to get up on little improved volume lately. It's moved up to this level, so if it can get above that, just check the watch list. That's basically also at the center Bollinger Band, so that's also the 10-day moving average. So you can watch it that. Break above that, we could go up and test the 50-day EMA. All these, of course, on the watch list. You can look at the full-size charts there. WDC, it's been moved over its trend line, had a little consolidation, but the same kind of volume as it moved up. If it can stay in here, starts moving back above this 25.50 area to 25.95 area, that may be a buy as well. And NR, Newport Resources there, I believe, in oil services, an oil services waste company, had very nice volume moving up. And look, when it had run up from the lows in the $5 area, the high fives and through the sixes, had very good strength moving up as well. Lower volume when it's been consolidating here. It's trying to move up again. Maybe it'll pull back, but if it can get back over this 881, or maybe over the high of the day 894, somewhere in there, maybe a good possibility. Or watch for a pullback on very light volume and see if there might be an entry coming in. SPWRA is not a typical, but because of this really high volume up near 8 million shares as it moved up on Friday and 3 million on the pullback, it might give an opportunity to repurchase this either if this little space here from yesterday's low, which we have marked on the watch list, if that holds, or getting down to the center band, which is around, this is lower than 10, but I think 10 should hold. But watch this one over the next couple days for a possible turn back up, because if there's so much movement up, its chances they'll at least try it once again, they'll be worth the trade. QLGC also had an old decent day, and just at the end it lost that, but if it can get back over its high of the day, 1531, or actually 1539 was, or 1533 is over here left, that could also move back up to its 50-day as well. So those are the additions for this Tuesday. I hope you'll have a good trading day. We always have those ETFs. If the market goes down, we don't have enough shorts that are triggering on the watch list, you can hold on to an ETF. So have a good day. Thanks a lot for coming by the site. Stop in the chat room, say hi, and we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks. Bye-bye.